Hello students, this is Monica, PGT in Computer Science from G.K.Jain High Secondary School. And today I am going to explain Chapter 2 Number System, and this chapter is common for both 11th Standard Computer Science and Computer Applications. Students, you have to really concentrate on this chapter since there will be definitely one question from this chapter as a problem question. And going to the number system, before getting into the topic, first you want to know what is machine language. And I told you already in my chapter first video what is machine language and what is assembly language is all about. Number system generally deals with the machine language. Since because if a user suppose giving an input to the computer, for example say any number or character or a special characters to the system, the system will generally convert that input into the numbers. It can be either 0 or 1. That zeros and ones tends to be a machine language. And either a 0 or a 1, that is one digit, either 10 or 11, it tends to be a bit. Bit is nothing but binary digit. The short form of binary digit will be your bit. And 4 bits combined together, for example, you can say 4 zeros or 4 ones, either 20 or 21, that will be your nibble. And 8 bits combined together will form a byte. And you have here kilobyte, megabyte, gigabyte, terabyte. And after this also you have petabyte, exa, zeta and yotta. So all this comes under your number data representations. For example, for taking kilobyte, the kilobyte value will be your 1024 bytes. How it comes? It is nothing but 2 power 10. You have to multiply 2 with 10 times. 2 into 2 etc. to 10 times will give you this size 1024. Same way you have to multiply 220 times, 2 power 20 will be your megabyte, 2 power 30 is giga, 2 power 40 is tera. Same way peta, exa, zeta and yotta, all 2 power 50, 60, 70 and 80. That give you the sizes which I mentioned over here. And going to the number systems, you have 4 different types of numbers. For example, you have decimal number system, octal number system, hexadecimal and finally a binary number system. Based on the numbers, count of numbers, whatever you are having in each number system will be your base value. Base value is nothing but it is the count of number of numbers. For example, if you have 0 and 1 in a binary, you will have the base value as 2. Since because you will have only 2 numbers, 0 and 1. So the base value of binary will be 2. And say for decimal, you will have 0 to 9 numbers. So you have totally 10 numbers. So the base value of decimal is 10. And for octal, you have 0 to 7. Total is 8 elements. So the base value of octal will be 8. And for hexadecimal, you will have 16 numbers altogether. 0 to 9 will be 10 count. So after 9, we won't explain it as 10, 11, 12. We will say it as alphabet A, B, C, D, E and F. So for hexadecimal, you have to say 0 to 9. And after 9, it is alphabet A, B, C, D, E and F. So totally 16 elements. So base value of hexadecimal will be 16. And I already told you what is base value. Base value plays a major role in the number system since because the total number of elements present in the number system will be its base value, or it is called as radix. And number, coming to the number conversions, it is very very important topic. I told you before the video itself, we have to concentrate on the number conversions since because you will have a definite question in your exam, either a 2-mark, 3-mark or even 5-mark questions. Number conversions. If any number is given, for example, if binary is given, convert to decimal. Or if binary is given, convert to octal. If decimal is given, convert to this number. So if the question asks like that, you have to solve the problem by doing the conversion method. I'll start with the first method, that is decimal to binary conversion and vice versa, binary to decimal conversion. Let me start with the first conversion technique. For example, if you want to convert, the question is given like convert this binary number to a decimal number, equivalent decimal number. We have to follow this process. If the number is given like 100001 base 2, so from the base itself you can identify it is a binary. If suppose a question is given like 0 1000, instead of 0 it is printed as 2 or 3, it definitely it will not be a binary number, because binary number will be 0 or 1. So from the place value you have to start. This will be your least bit and this will be your most significant bit. You have to start from the right side corner. The first number will take a base value of 2 with its place value 0. So you have to start here from 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on. So you have to take with the base value what is given, 2. So 2 power the place value, the 1 is in the 0th place. So 2 power 0, 2 power 1, 2 power 2, 2 power 3 and so on. So you have to multiply this 1 with 2 power 0 and 0 with 2 power 1 and here 0 with 2 power 2, here 0 with 2 power 3, here 0 with 2 power 4, here 0 with 2 power 5 and here 1 with 2 power 6. You have to multiply all the numbers and you have to finally add the numbers. For example, anything power 0 will be 1. Even it is 100 power 0 also, anything power 0 will be 1. So 2 power 0 will be 1. 2 power 1 is 2. 2 square is 4. 2 power 3 is 8. 2 power 4 is 16. 2 power 5 is 32. 2 power 6 is 64. You have to multiply this number with the question given. So exactly 1 will be multiplied with 64 and here 1 will be multiplied with 1. All the rest numbers will be 0 because it is multiplied with 0. So you have to finally add the numbers. 64 plus 1 will be your decimal number, equivalent decimal number base 10. And definitely you have to mention the base value, it is more and more important. For same way, if decimal number is given to you, convert the decimal to a binary, then what we'll do, you have to divide with the binary base value. For example, 65 is given as a decimal number, you have to divide with 2. So 32 is 64, so you have remainder 1, and 32 is 16, you will not have any remainder, so it's 0. 16 by 2 is 8, you will have remainder 0. 8 by 2 is 4 and same way you don't have any remainder. 4 by 2 is 2, no remainder. 2 by 2 is 1 and you have 0 remainder. All the even numbers will have 0 reminders, only the odd number will carry 1 reminder. So you have to, starting from here, you have to write all the numbers. 100000 and 1 will be your equivalent binary number. Here is your second type. If the number given is octal, you have to convert to decimal, or vice versa, if decimal is given, you have to convert to octal. The same procedure what we followed for decimal to binary. Same way, if 547 base 8, 8 will be recognition of your octal number and the question must be within 0 to 7. You have to check the question also. Because if the base value is 8, the question will be from 0 to 7. And the same procedure what we follow. The last least significant bit will be your 7. So you have to start with 7. The place value is 0, so 8 power 0. And 4, 8 power 1, 5, 8 power 2. So 8 power 0 is 1. So 7 into 1. And here 4 into 8. And here 5 into 8 square is 64. So 5 into 64. So 5 into 64 is 320. 4 into 8 is 32. 7 into 1 will be your 7. And you have to add all the numbers together. Please be careful with adding the numbers with the same positional values. And here, if decimal number is given to you, the decimal number you have to convert to a binary number. You have to follow the procedure as the same I told you already. Like, you have to divide with the octal number. 65 is a decimal value, and you have to divide the decimal value with the base value 8. And here decimal 65 with the base value 8. So 65 will be 8 times of 8. So it is 8 8s are 64. And 8 will be 1 times of 8. So 1 and 0. And you have to start your number from the most significant bit. From here to here. So 1, 0 and 0 will be the equivalent octal number. And the next method will be your decimal and hexadecimal conversion. Same way, if hexadecimal number is given, for example 25 base 16, you have to convert this hexadecimal number to decimal. What we have to do? We have to multiply with the base value with its place value. So 5, 16 power 0, 2, 16 power 1. And same way, anything power 0 will be 1. So 5 into 1 and 2 into 16 will be your 32. You have to add two numbers and this will be your equivalent decimal number. And same way, if decimal number is given for you to convert into hexadecimal, the procedure is same as follows. You have to multiply with the hexadecimal value the decimal number. So 16 will be 1 times of 31 and you have 15 as the reminder. 15 you have to search with the table, like after 9 you cannot write 10, 11, 12. You have to write A, B, C, D. So 15 number is equivalent to the alphabet F. So answer will be 1 and F. You have to start from here. MSB to least significant bit LSB. So you will have to write it like this. 1 and 15. 15 have to be written as F. So 1 and F. And students, today we discussed about the number systems. We practiced three types, like decimal to binary and binary to decimal, hexadecimal and decimal, and octal and decimal. I hope you enjoy the class today, and we will see you. We have further more problems also in second chapter. I will explain you in my next video, students. Thank you so much.